Hello students, I'm Dr. Harshit Bhanushali. What I'm going to do today is I'm going to analyze the NEET 2021 bio paper. We'll see the overview of the paper. We will see the unit-wise distribution of questions. We will see the type-wise distribution of questions. This information would help you to strategize and plan your biology studies, your biology preparation for the next NEET papers. If you're a student who's planning to appear for NEET in 2022, 23, whatever, you would be able to use this information to plan your revision, to plan your studies, to understand the future NEET biology papers. So we start with the discussion and the analysis of the 21 paper. The first information which is important to note is that this year the distribution of questions was equal. You had 50 questions coming from the 11th NCERT textbook and 50 questions coming from the 12th NCERT textbook. Mind you, this was the first year where you had 100 questions with the distribution of 70-30 optional section, as well as 70 was the compulsory section and the 30 was the optional section. So you had 100 questions in the paper, out of which 50 questions were asked from the 11th NCERT textbook and the remaining 50 were asked from the 12th NCERT textbook. Now, this is different compared to last year where you had 90 questions, out of which you had 48 coming from 11th and 42 from 12th. For your information, if you see in the slide, the numbers which are given in bracket are the 2020 distribution of marks. This would help you to identify and understand how the papers have changed over a period of 2020 to 21. So the distribution this year in 11th and 12th has been more even if you compare to the other years. If you talk of the type of questions which have been asked, you had the match the column type of questions, which was 17 in number. So you had 17 questions which were match the column type. This is the exact same figure what you had last year too. Even last year, there were 17 match the column questions which were asked. But if you ask me, the match the column type of questions this year were comparatively more easy. The second type of questions which were there were statement-based questions, which were 15 in number as compared to 2020, where you had 16 statement-based questions. When I mean statement-based questions, I mean questions whereby you are given statements to find out whether they are true, whether they are false. You are given sequences of statements to find out the answers of. The example type of questions, whereby you were asked examples of certain organisms, or where you were given examples of certain organisms, the examples which are there in your NCERT, there were 7 such questions this year as opposed to 6 in 2020. No questions were asked on researchers, on discoverers, as opposed to 2 questions which were asked last year. This year, none of the scientists' names were asked in the paper. Like every year, the largest bulk of the questions was the direct type of questions, whereby a question is asked and the answer is in the form of a direct word or a direct line. This year, you had 61 such questions which were asked as opposed to 49 questions which were asked last year. So overall, mind you, of course, the number of questions were greater this year by a figure of 10. So you have to note that we had 100 questions this year. So the distribution of questions has been more or less the same as last year, excepting no scientist questions were asked. Diagram-based questions were not asked this year. They were neither asked last year. So you have the largest chunk of questions, which were the direct questions, which were 61. The second largest questions were the statement-based questions, the match the column questions, which were 17 in number. You had statement-based questions, which were 15. You have example-type questions, which were 7. And then you had no questions which came from the researchers. What you have to note, although, is all these questions which came were from the NCERT. So the entire paper, like 2020, was an NCERT-based paper which was asked. Now, a few observations regarding the paper which were different and which were not so convincing, according to my opinion. The first thing, if you observe in the 2021 NEET paper, is that they had divided it into botany and zoology. Though they had a dedicated botany section and zoology section, if you go through the paper, you would find the questions were not clearly demarcated. the question on evolution. One question was asked on zoology in the botany section. The other question was asked in the zoology section. Even in the enhancement section, the enhancement in food production chapter, plant breeding section about crop improvement, one of the questions was asked in the zoology section. The mutation breeding was asked in the botany question. So that was another thing. Biomolecules, you had one question, you know, half questions, around two questions which were asked in botany. The other two were asked in zoology section. Molecular basis of inheritance was a major scatter. You had molecular basis of inheritance asked in both the sections. Same for questions on cell, questions on cell division. And if you observe biotechnology application chapter, you would find questions on this chapter were asked on both the botany side as well as the zoology side. So this was the first year whereby you had botany zoology section in the NEET paper, but they didn't do a great job in demarcating the questions into proper clear-cut botany and zoology. Another thing what I observed this year is multiple questions being asked from a single section or a single part of the chapter. For example, PCR, there were around 2 to 3 questions just on PCR. Then the questions on the paragraph of adaptation. So you had two questions which directly came from one single part of the chapter, organisms and population. So from the adaptation chapter, you had two questions coming, which is ideally unusual. You know, you can't be so concentrated on one single paragraph. Secondary metabolites, there were two questions which came from the same table of the NCERT textbook. So multiple questions coming from single topic was something which is not an ideal scenario in case of the NEET paper. The other thing what I observed was an uneven distribution of the question, as in there was not even a single question which came from the nervous system chapter. There was not even a single question which came from the chapter of excretion. There was a question on erythropoietin hormone, but of course, ideally that should be included in the chemical coordination chapter. So on one hand, nervous system didn't have any question. You didn't have any question from excretion. On the other hand, you had several questions coming from molecular basis of inheritance, several questions coming from biotech. Mind you, even last year, biotech section, the unit of biotech had a large number of questions, this year too. But I find this distribution of questions a bit uneven, and I'm hoping and I'm expecting that in the next year's paper, this uneven distribution would change. Another thing what we found new is the presence of the assertion reason type of questions, which is not usually asked in NEET. So there were two types of questions which were unusual this year. One was the assertion reason question, which was asked for the very first time, if I'm not wrong, according to the NEET 2000, according to new NEET pattern. Of course, the assertion reason type of question was asked in the optional section. So that was something which was fine accordingly. The other question which came was the question on earthworm, which is a bit of a controversial part because even last year this had happened. Earthworm technically has been deleted from the NEET portion according to the NEET portion which was given. So they asked this year too, but it was in the optional part of the chapter. So this was the understanding of the question-wise analysis of the NEET paper. We go next now to the discussion on the unit-wise distribution of the paper as opposed to what you saw in 2020. Unit 1, you had 10 questions which were there. Last year, there were 8 questions. Out of that living world, you had a single question for biological classification, and the major chunk coming from plant kingdom and animal kingdom. This is usual to what you expect from Unit 1. You generally get 8 to 10 questions. So this was something which was on expected lines. In Unit 2, you had 9 questions coming this year as opposed to 8 in 2020, whereby you had less questions coming from morphology and you had greater questions, larger number of questions coming from the chapter structural organization of animals. So you had 2 questions only from the morphology chapter, you had 3 from anatomy, and you had 4 questions coming from structural organization chapter. Unit 3, you had the cell unit where you had 4 questions coming from bio, from cell chapter, 4 coming from biomolecules, and a huge number considering the size of the chapter is a chapter cell division. You had 5 questions from such a small chapter. So 13 questions came from this unit. Generally, you would have in the range of 8 to 10 questions coming from this unit. But this year, they asked 13 questions which came from this unit. The major increase this time was from the cell chapter and the cell division chapter. Of course, cell chapter is a big chapter. So asking four from that is something which is not unusual. But if you ask me, asking five questions from the cell division chapter is a bit of too much. This should help you to understand that this is not a chapter to be ignored, because though it is a small chapter, last year you had four questions coming from it. This year you had five which came from this chapter. This unit, the unit four, according to me, is the most neglected unit in your NEET paper in 2020 as well as 2021. You had only eight questions coming from this unit, in spite of this unit having five chapters. So there were eight questions which came from this, as opposed to last year or nine questions which were asked in 2020. Transport in plants is, according to me, one of the most neglected chapter in the last 2 years. A single question was asked from this particular chapter, in spite of this chapter being pretty big in size and pretty important too. Mineral nutrition, you had single question as compared to last two questions asked last year, which is fine because it's not such a big chapter. You had two questions from photosynthesis, which is expected length. You had one question only which came from the chapter respiration in plants. I think they could have asked two in this. And you had three questions coming from plant growth, which is usual as expected. So this unit four, transport in plants, the number of questions have reduced year by year. It has come to one, as opposed to what the size and the difficulty level of this chapter, what it is. Unit five, had 10 questions. Again, if you observe, the number of chapters in these are too many. This is one of the biggest units. This is the unit of your entire human physiology. But the number of questions which were asked were less comparatively. In spite of this unit having around seven chapters, you had only 10 questions coming from it. You had not even a single question from nervous system. You didn't have any single question from excretion. There was only one question on erythropoietin which was asked, which is an NCRT line in the chapter chemical coordination. So as opposed to questions which had been expected, the number is comparatively less since there was no question which was asked in excretion and nervous system. Last year they had asked two questions of excretion. They had asked one question of nervous system. This time they didn't ask many. Locomotion, they asked three questions this year, which is a bit unusual considering the size of the chapter. Otherwise, more or less, if you see digestion, breathing and exchange, the circulation chapter, there was an even distribution of two questions. The only chapters which were missed out this year were the two chapters which I already mentioned in this unit. So another unit which I should say would be a neglected unit. We go on to the 12th standard NCRT textbook, the reproduction unit, which is unit number six. There were 10 questions asked this year as compared to eight which were asked last year. Out of that, there was a single question from reproduction in organism. There were three questions which came from sexual reproduction in plants. There were three from human reproduction. Both of this is unexpected lines. Reproductive health, they asked three questions this year, which according to me is a bit too much considering the size of the chapter. So considering the size of the chapter, they had three questions which were asked of this chapter, which according to me is a bit too much considering the small size. So yes, 10 questions which were asked from this unit, that is unit number six. You come to unit number seven, there were 13 questions which are asked. Obviously, this is an important unit. This is a unit which includes the genetics chapters of principles of inheritance, and you had molecular basis of inheritance. If you remember in the beginning of this lecture, in the video, I told you molecular basis of inheritance was unevenly distributed. You had nine questions coming from this chapter, half of them being asked in botany, the other half being asked in zoology. According to me, this is not a correct distribution of questions. I don't expect this distribution to be repeated next year. I expect this to become more even. Evolution is a considerably important chapter. Last year they had asked four questions. This year only two questions were asked from this. So not on expected lines. I don't expect this distribution to be repeated in the next year, because the original distribution which was there of 3-4-4 was something which was on expected lines. This year they've asked nine questions of molecular basis of inheritance. I don't expect that to be repeated next year. This, according to me, has been the unit which has been neglected for the past 2 years, you know, considering that it has the health and disease chapter, the number of questions which could have come from this unit would have been greater. There was only a single question which came from human health and disease. There were 4 questions which came from enhancement chapter and a single question of microbes. So number of questions from human health and disease chapter could have been more, but overall, compared to last year, the number of questions of the unit are the same, but it could rise because it's a considerably important unit. This unit, again, as I already told you, is a unit where there was an uneven distribution of marks. Compared to the size of the unit, the number of questions were too many. There were 12 questions asked from a unit where there are only 2 chapters, which are technically complicated chapters, but not too big as chapters in size. You had 6 coming from biotech processes chapter and 6 coming from biotech applications chapter. Now, this is 3 more than what they asked in 2020. Listen, student, always remember the genetic section has always been the heavy section of NEET. The genetic section always has larger number of questions compared to the other sections with regards to their weightages. But 12 is still a huge number. I am expecting in the next year, it will go back to 9 questions. But this year, there were too many questions which came from the biotech chapters, 12 to be precise, as compared to 9 which were asked last year. The last unit, the unit of the entire ecology chapters, had again an uneven distribution because there wasn't a single question which was asked from the biodiversity chapter, which was not something which we expected. There were 5 questions coming from organism and population, again uneven. Out of that, I already told you, the adaptation paragraph had 2 questions coming. So you had 5 questions coming from organism and population. You had 3 questions coming from ecosystem. You had no question of biodiversity and just a single question which had come from environmental issues chapter. If you see last year, it was a very evenly based questioning whereby 2 questions were asked from each of the chapter. So this year it was not followed. It was an uneven scattering of the questions with 5 questions just coming from organism and population. In the next year, I expect this to be rectified. I expect in the next year that you will again have an even distribution of 2 questions coming from each of the chapter in this unit. So this is the entire unit-wise distribution of the entire chapter. This basically explains the entire analysis of the NEET 2021 paper. This hopefully should help you plan your bio NEET preparations in the future. So all the best, students, for your NEET preparation. That's it from my side. Thank you.